I wanted my research to impact the community. And so I felt that SLU's mission to serve others would help me take my research and translate it to policy.
The St. Louis region is embracing a great opportunity for potentially becoming a national hub for geospatial research. Within the university, we have a really strong, diverse research community that utilizes geospatial tools, which is unique and also a defining strength for St. Louis University. My current research projects focuses on food, water, and energy nexus, monitoring food and water security under climate and anthropogenic changes. Number of projects, but one is to use multi-scale remote sensing for improved crop productivity. Demand for food and agricultural products are projected to increase by about more than 50% by 2050. You see the value or power of geospatial tools.
I came to HIV infection primarily because it's not fair. And then I realized that the proper term around that is health inequity. I look at how neighborhoods influence behavior. Do neighborhood conditions influence health outcomes among people living with HIV? We actually are identifying that there are worse outcomes if you live in a poor neighborhood, even if you have access to care. So I'm a behavioral scientist, and I come to geospatial analysis by looking at how are these two things interweaving and how are they influencing each other. Where you live shouldn't dictate how long you live and how good of a life you live.
My research is at the intersection of inequality and spatial-temporal statistics. I do a lot of demographic work, but I wanted to take those tables and visualize them over a map. The bigger the scale we look at, oftentimes it masks what's going on within the zip code or within the neighborhood. So we developed this technique called microdemography, very, very small levels of analysis. Part of what we're trying to do is bring these maps so people can see their life story through those maps and look at the assets and challenges in their surrounding block and in the surrounding neighborhood. It makes it personal for them, saying, I want to do something about this. We really want to empower people to be at the table using us as a resource, helping them dream about a vision that they see for their neighborhoods.
Very few of the problems today can be resolved by a one discipline. We partner with faculty and researchers at SLU and also in the nation.
SLU and researchers specifically are looking at why location matters. It matters to your health outcomes, to your employment opportunities, matters to your education attainment.
There is demand academically to push the field forward scientifically, how we think about social and economic phenomena spatially. But I think from an applied perspective, because of SLU's mission and because of where SLU is located, we can really make an impact in neighborhoods that have opportunities for redevelopment, opportunities to attract resources, but to kind of understand what the assets are, they simply need a map.